Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. And now to my guest, Michael Duran. He is a senior fellow at the Hudson Institute. My extremely well-read producer believes this is the finest piece that he has seen on the Mueller investigation. It is written for National Review, and it is up at DennisPrager.com. It is titled The Real Collusion Story. And the subtitle, in a textbook example of denial and projection, Trump foes in and out of government wove a sinister yarn meant to take him down. Michael Duran, welcome to the Dennis Prager Show.
Hi, thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure indeed. Let me ask you, did anything surprise you?
Yes. Yeah, I wasn't expecting the devil of the story. I mean, the ringmaster of the collusion turns out to be John Brennan, and I was not expecting that. I knew he had a role, but as I started the piece, I went week by week and put it all together, and his role just loomed larger and larger. Once I realized that, it made perfect sense, because the director of the CIA is the guy who is in a position to pull it all together, and the personality of John Brennan is, you know, particularly political. So it wasn't surprising afterwards, but I wasn't expecting it.
I didn't either. So tell us about him. He was an Obama appointee, correct?
He was an Obama appointee, but he's really a Clinton guy. I didn't go into this in the article, by the way. But Brennan, there are a couple of things about Brennan that make him distinctive as a CIA director. One of them is that he is almost certainly the only CIA director ever to have voted for a communist for president of the United States. He, in 76, he voted in a youthful rebellion. He voted for Gus Hall instead of Jimmy Carter. Jimmy Carter wasn't left-wing enough for him. So he went
Gus Hall. Gus Hall was the chairman of the Communist Party USA.
Yeah, so John Brennan voted for him. He's admitted this himself. The other thing is that, the CIA is divided into the DI and the DO. The DI is the analysis directorate, and the DO is operations. And sociologically, the DI is full of the same kind of people you find in graduate schools and Ivy League universities. I mean, then with all of the same attitudes. The DO is made up of people more like what you find in the military. You know, they want to go out and do stuff. The DI sits in their cubicles and analyze stuff. And typically, heads of the CIA, with some major exceptions, but typically they come from the DO. But Brennan came from the DI. And he made the switch over in the Clinton administration, because he used to give Bill Clinton his daily briefing, and they made a personal connection. And then Clinton sent him to be the chief of station in Saudi Arabia in the 90s. So that's how he became at the top ranks of the CIA.
But all right, hold on. It's like a mystery story. Michael Duran's article is up at DennisPrager.com. I asked him if anything surprised him. He said, and that is, now let me see if I'm getting you correctly, that ultimately the real mastermind behind this, what you and I and half of the country believe is a fraudulent investigation into collusion with Russia on the part of the Trump campaign, is, in fact, John Brennan. Is that correct?
Yes, that's what I think.
Okay, I would just like to read this weekend's tweet from John Brennan to show the hatred that animates this man with regard to Donald Trump. When the full extent of your venality, moral turpitude, and political corruption becomes known, you will take your rightful place as a disgraced demagogue in the dustbin of history. You may scapegoat Andy McCabe, but you will not destroy America. America will triumph over you. I assume that is how he has felt for a long time.
That's exactly how I see it. And I think, you know, when you look at all the things that Obama was saying about Trump, Brennan's now saying about Trump, that the never-Trumpers were saying about Trump, you know, threat to democracy and fascism rising, all of that. You have to say, you have to assume they truly believe what they're saying. And that then gives them a sense of justification to do whatever it takes to take him down.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. You can lie. You can smear. New York Times published a piece this weekend about the why aren't Jews more concerned with this massive rise in anti-Semitism since Donald Trump was elected? It's a gargantuan lie that the guy wrote in the New York Times. But it's okay to do that.
I miss that one. Of course, that's been one of the themes all along. And they, of course, you know, never reported on the fact that under Obama, you know, the left became much more virulently anti-Semitic. I mean, that's documentable. It's not a fantasy.
That's exactly right. But left-wing anti-Semitism does not disturb left-wing Jews. That's the point. And the guy who wrote it was a left-wing Jew. I'm a Jew. I could say this, so you don't have to get nervous.
I'm not Jewish, but I work in my profession. I'm surrounded by them all the time, so I'm very familiar with their attitudes.
Yes, indeed. So am I, to say the least. All right. So what is it? All right. So if he's the, what does it mean then? What does it mean? He's the mastermind. What did he do?
I didn't go into the origins of the investigation deeply. Let me just throw it out there. We don't have to talk about it. I believe that the investigation starts with this Papadopoulos thing. I suggested in the article that was also trumped up by Brennan. But once the FBI opens up the Trump-Russia investigation, Brennan starts putting pressure on Comey to go public with the information that Trump and his team are under investigation in order to help Hillary in the election. That's the whole goal.
On what grounds does Brennan pressure Comey?
On two grounds. One, he's saying that he has information that proves that Putin is trying to help Hillary in the election. It all goes back to the hack of the DNC. That not just that this was carried out by the Russians, but that the goal was to install Trump, that there's evidence of this, and he wants Comey to go public with it, and Comey is refusing to do that. Secondly, he's saying that there is credible evidence that members of Trump's team are in cahoots with Putin. And that, of course, is based on the Steele dossier, on the lies of the Steele dossier, which we know were paid for and cooked up by the Hillary Clinton campaign.
What was Brennan's position in the government at the time he did this with Comey?
Director of the CIA.
Oh, he was then director of the CIA. So,
that's right.
Okay. Well, so the director of the CIA obviously has clout with the director of the FBI.
That's right, but he doesn't have the legal right to investigate American citizens. So Comey has two things that Brennan needs. Comey is withholding the affirmation that Putin's intention is to install Trump. So Brennan can't put together an intelligence community-wide assessment that supports the propaganda of Hillary Clinton about the intentions of the Russians. And the other thing that Comey has is the ability to investigate American citizens. And what Brennan wants is for Comey to go public and say that Trump is under investigation by the FBI.
So you believe that Comey would not have gone to the FISA court? If it wasn't Comey who went to the FISA court?
Yes.
So do you believe he would not have, were it not for Brennan?
I believe that he came under, who knows what he would have done were it not for Brennan, but he came under pressure from Brennan to do that. And then he did it.
And Brennan, why is Brennan no longer the CIA director?
Just because of the election.
So was he fired? Was he? Did he quit? What happened?
No, he left with the Obama team, and then Trump put in his own director. That's pretty standard. It's more the FBI where they tend to go over between administrations.
I have Michael Duran on the line, senior fellow at the Hudson Institute. Michael Comey says that he will be publishing his book. It's coming out in mid-April, and that it's going to have all these revelations, and then people will really see what Donald Trump is like. What do you think he's talking about?
You know, I don't think that there's going to be much in there that we don't already know. He's already testified before Congress. If he had something really revelatory, you know, we would have heard about it through Mueller. He's just hyping his book. The problem he's going to have is that the Inspector General of the Justice Department, Horowitz, is going to be coming out with his report at about the same time, and that is going to make Comey's FBI look like a shambles.
Well, is that a report or a book?
That's going to be a report, a government report.
Oh, that's fascinating. Oh, wow. I tell you, even somebody who doesn't have a sense of personal involvement here like most Americans do, but, you know, I'm in Australia now. Even an Australian would probably find this fascinating. We didn't even get to Mueller, so if it's okay with you, we're going to do a part two, okay?
Okay, great. Thank you.
No, thank you. His piece is up at DennisPrager.com.